In the recent years, the coexistence between Ugandans in the four West Nile districts of Yumbe, Koboko, Moyo, and Adjumani, with the South Sudanese from the countries of Kajokeji, Morobu, and Lanya in the central Equatorial State, along the borders of Uganda and South Sudan, has been marred by conflicts. During the joint cross-border security meeting between the leaders from Uganda and South Sudan at Yumbe District Headquarters, leaders agreed on finding a lasting solution to the clashes. The South Sudan delegation was led by the governor of the Central Equatorial State, Emmanuel Adil Anthony, and the Ugandan leaders were drawn from Adjumani, Moyo, Yumbe, and Koboko districts. Yumbe District Chairperson Abdul Mutalib Asik says the clashes caused displacement of thousands of people along the borders. These also lost lives and property. He emphasized the need to implement the resolutions passed by the leaders.
Your Excellency, I have consistently presented in the previous meetings, unless a secretariat is established, both for Uganda and South Sudan, to follow up on the implementation of the key resolutions, that will be wasting our time if these secretariats are not established to follow up the implementation of the resolutions.
Ambassador Antipas Nyok Dekucha, the Director of Borders and Foreigners in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs in South Sudan, said it's unfortunate that the two communities fight over the international boundary, which was created later after the communities had even existed before as brothers and sisters. He appealed to the leaders to leave discussions of international boundaries to the two heads of state. The leaders called for an end to the clashes.
Sudan got its map in 1956. And Uganda got its map in 1962, and Kenya in 1963. We will be using these maps, and we will be using consultation from the elders at local level. So there is no point for land grabbing or competition over the land. After all, this land belongs to all of us. If it is a land in Uganda, it is for the people of South Sudan. If it is a land in South Sudan, it is belong to people of Uganda. Like now, we have so many refugees here. They are not sleeping in heaven. They are sleeping on the ground, which means the land belongs to them.
The governor of Central Equatorial State of South Sudan, Emmanuel Adil Anthony, commended the leaders of Uganda for the peace ideas.
It's indicated that our people that we represent in these meetings have not been made aware or do consent to our meetings. It portrays inability to mobilize our people to represent whom we represent, to obey our meeting resolutions, and become part of the implementation of those resolutions. Instead, both authorities of local government across the border to show leadership in harmonizing such unnecessary violence. The leaders become indulged or drawn to footprints of violence by proxy or indirectly.
He asked the two communities to review the cultures and norms that kept them in harmony for decades.
For whatever reason that the colonialists drew the current borders, the borderlines should not be used for undermining, obstructing, or perpetuating crimes, transfer travelers, and deny users the rights of existence. We need to revisit our cultural values that kept us around together for many past decades and centuries.
Report compiled by Adam Gule for the news.